الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. First of all, I'd like to thank your excellence ambassador of Iraq for inviting us for the celebration of Eid. May Allah make it a peaceful Eid for all of us. It was and it will be inshallah. Talk about terrorism is not a teaching of any prophet. It's not a teaching of any reformer. It's not a teaching of any wise man or wise woman. Not a part of our culture in the Middle East. It's not a part of our culture as Muslims. Never it was and never it will be. Something which has been imposed upon us by the narrow-mindedness of individuals who do not understand the peace of Islam that can bring to humanity. My relationship with Iraq goes 20 years ago with my first visit. It went from Basra, Kufa, Karbala, Najaf, Baghdad, of course, Mosul, Heath, Ana, Rawa, Haditha, Ambar, Ramadi, anything else? Kirkuk. And I felt the pain when I was visiting one of the greatest country on earth. On earth, not on the Arab world. Richest in knowledge, history, technology, civilization, culture, arts, everything. That's why you are targeted. If you are poor of all this, nobody could have targeted Iraq. Iraq is an icon for humanity. It's not just a country. I've got the greatest rivers from heaven, Tigray and Euphrates. And a nation that goes back thousands and thousands and thousands of years. The father of all the prophets was Iraqi national, isn't it? We give him a passport. That's why we give, in Egypt, we give Moses, peace be upon him, an Egyptian passport. Jacob, Egyptian passport, and Yusuf, Egyptian passport as well. So when we look at this depth of history and culture and art and everything in a country like that, by itself, I bowed down to it. And I never cried for any country more than I cried for my country, Iraq. Because I can see the diversity and the complexity of the culture and the wisdom. Scholars, scientists come from Iraq. Different cities in Iraq, different backgrounds, different mosaics. We should keep Iraq, we should fight for it, because this is the icon for Islam, for Muslims, for Arabs, and for humanity. This is the Iraq that I love. Besides the point that I love Pacha. There's Pacha today?
Friday.
No, not today. That's, we are not eating with you today. You can explain, Your Excellency, what the meal means. Well, His Excellency will tell you later on. You take it for breakfast. I was in Iraq last year with the Red Crescent, tried to do something for the World Humanitarian Summit, and that was Dr. Yassin. And this is my personal relationship with a country that I love, I keep loving. Not because you are beautiful people, but because you made history and you created civilization. And you will be able to create more civilization because you are able nation, and you are a nation that's resilient and know what to do. So I don't want to take too much of your time, but I will say here, I was talking to my colleague about the role of civil society organizations in building societies, building nations, and building civilizations. A country that does not have a strong civil society, organizations, and sector is a fragile country. Is a fragile country. Could be infiltrated by any group, any handful of people, to change it from a fragile country into a failing country. It is very serious. We have to fight hard to build our civil society sector in every country. Enjoy it here in UK, because hundreds of thousands of humanitarian and civil society organizations to complement the role of the government, private business, and academia in our country, our civilization were based on love. And how the individual Muslims and Christians, our area, were actually through the Waqf system, were able to nurture the country and build a stronger state. Once you fight the civil society and the civilian, you become a fragile state and you become a failing state later on. So I second what you were discussing with me earlier on. We need to bring Iraq back to its path, global path, by building a very strong civil society sectors and organization to fight those sick people which you mentioned in your speech. I'd like to thank you and Eid Mubarak.